Okay, one announcement. We have midterm exam next Tuesday, and we don't have class on Thursday, okay, which is 28th, right? 28th of this month, right? 28th, we don't have class, okay. All right. Okay, let's get started. Let's talk some more about experiment environment and also hardware design, right? Guyun did. By the way, there was a little problem in hardware design. So Guyun fixed it and committed it to into you know GitHub. So if you check GitHub page, so this this page was updated 21 hours ago. So if you have already downloaded and tested it, then please do it again, right? Download the hardware design again. So little, you know, change. Not major change.
그 사실 이미 그 하고 과제까지 제출을 했는데 25명으로.
That is okay then. That is okay.
아, 네. 감사합니다.
Yeah. Okay. Okay. So yeah, little change though. So if you have already submitted homework, then don't worry about that. Okay, so let's back up a little bit and talk about environment first, okay, to refresh your memory. That is our hardware design, this box, right? This box is our hardware design inside the PL, right? This one will be downloaded. And we have a connection to this camera, right? And the PL, you know, PLL inside the clock manager, right? Clock manager inside PL is generating clock to generating clock and connect, send it to the camera, right? And camera is sending a video stream through, you know, this interface. So if we focus on this. So this is the one, right? Some detailed signal, right? Interface signal, right? You have power and ground, and these two. Okay, let me better to open. Official data sheet, right? This one. So if you see this block diagram, SIO, clock and data, SIO, serial, you know, IO, I think, serial IO and clock, D, stand for data, right? So using these two wires, you can set configuration. Basically, you can program those registers, okay, to set configuration, okay? So what kind of configuration? So you need to read this documentation to figure out what kind of configuration you can set. But some, you know, advanced features, right, like this, right? You can some features, right? You can configure video format, like do you want to use YUV format? Color coding, right? RGB format. Which format do you want to use? Right? You can set, you know, color coding scheme using, you know, configuration register. Also, some advanced function which I don't fully understand. Some automatic image control function, including automatic exposure control, blah blah blah, black level calibration. I don't know. Right, but if you are, you know, familiar with this technology, then you can set configuration, right? For so before you use camera, you can set configuration. Then, you know, one thing I want to mention is this protocol, right? It's SIO, SIO C and D. That is basically based on I2C, you know, protocol, I2C. And that is originally proposed by Philips. So if you go to maybe page, you know, I2C specification. That is actually, you know, proposed by Philips. Then, you know, that became, you know, industry standard. You know, almost all, you know, chip manufacturers are using I2C communication. You know, as the name implies, right? Inter IC communication. Right? So good picture is, I think, this one. So inter-IC communication, it is very low-cost way of communicating between devices. Right? So like this, think about our, you know, board, right? So let's say these two, right? These two are actually DDR memory, but think of it as I/O devices. Think of it as LCD driver, this one, and the right side, this one, you can think of it as ADC, analog digital converter, right? And this microcontroller is JINC. You want to communicate with these two, okay? Then you can, on PCB, you can make, you know, I2C connection. If you have, you know, I2C output, input and output, right? So using these two wires, right? Using two wires, this microcontroller can touch registers inside LCD controller and analog digital converter. You know, super, you know, low cost of you know, communicating between devices because you need only two wires, right? So the details, details here, right? Details. So clock and data essentially, right? So clock, right? And data line. So data line goes down while clock is high, then means it is start, no signal. Okay. Transmission will be started. And opposite is stop, no condition. And data is transmitted bit by bit. Right, bit by bit. So to communicate between devices, the first information you have to send is address information, right? That is for sure, like this. So start, then many different devices are connected, right? So if you go up, so here, so many different devices from CPU, from processor, microcontroller, to many IO, many IC, right? Different devices. So you have to, you know, send the address information. So who is the target, right? LCD is the target or ADC, who is the target, right? So you have to send that address information. Right? That is the first packet, the address information. And then inside, right, assume that, you know, the ADC is selected. That guy is selected. Then there are many different registers inside ADC, right? So you have to send address information, you know, address information, which register you want to access, right? So second packet should be register address, then, you know, data, if you want to, you know, write. If you read, then your data, right? So, you know, very low cost way of communicating between devices, right? Using these two wires. So it is very popular. And, you know, our JINC device, if you click on this technical reference manual. You know, PS has I2C controller, right? I2C. Let me open this one. So look at this. So PS, we have two of them, right? Two I2C controller inside PS. So again, this is I²C is for inter IC communication, not inside, you know, SOC, you know, communication. Right? Inside SOC, we use, you know, XE, AMBA, right? AMBA interconnect to access I/O devices, right? And I²C is to connect to, you know, other chip, not inside SOC, right? Other chip, inter IC. All right, so, okay, too many document. Okay, so let me open this one, camera. So using I²C, you can set registers, okay? You set operating condition, like what kind of video format you want to use, right? And some advanced features. So once you set configuration, the normal operation, right? So you supply clock, and based on that, this camera module, right? Camera module is sending video stream through these, you know, pins. So important pins are clock. You are sending 48 megahertz clock from PL. In return, you are, you know, getting same 48 megahertz. So you are sending 48 megahertz, then you are getting the same, you know, 48 megahertz. And then important signals are vertical sync and the horizontal sync, basically, HREF. So the thing is, this video module, this video camera is sending ...640 pixels, then 48 pixel information, right? That is one, you know, image, one frame, right? So one frame. So in 1 second, it is able to send 30, you know, frames per second, okay, this image, okay? Then, you know, 640 pixels, okay? 640, you know, pixels, right? You have 480 of them, right? You can call this one row or line, right? Line number 0, then line number 479, 02479, right? So display one color in this pixel, you need, depending on the configuration, you can use either RGB, red, green, blue, or you can use YUV, right? RGB is very you know, intuitive, right? Red, green, blue. By mixing these three, then you can display any color, right? But YUV is a very widely used color coding scheme. You can Google search to figure out what, you know, YUV means, but you know this one? Y component is actually brightness. Brightness and UV color component. It is called chrominance. Okay. Brightness and color component. So using that information, you can send information. And in our case, the default setting of camera is this one, YUV. Okay. So that information is delivered through through this interface, data and VSync and HREF. You know, after sending, you know, so when you send the first line, right? Before you send the first line, let me check out specification. Look at this. so before you send this, you know, before you send this whole, one whole image, vertical sync, right? Vertical sync is asserted. That means this one frame is going to be sent, right? It's going to be sent. It's going to be sent to, to, you know, to the PL, right? Vertical sync. Then, while you are sending one line of data, okay, then horizontal sync, or you know, href is asserted. Okay, href is asserted. Then, camera is sending data. Okay, when this href is high, let me show you some detailed okay information. Look at this 640 pixel time. Okay, 640 pixel time, right? So then how many of them you have? One, two, look at this. 480 lines, right? You have 480 line information. So look at this, some detailed information. So href is high, then first byte information is sent, right? So on the PL side, you can store this information. You can store this information at the rising edge of the clock, right? At the rising edge of the clock, you can store this information. So href supposed to be high, right? And next rising edge of the clock, you store second byte, and then third byte, and so on, right? And then look at this. So if you select this format, okay, through I2C interface, if you select this video format, 565, then that information will be delivered, right? Look at this, RGB, R5 bit, red 5 bit, 723, and green 6 bit, 3 and 3, and blue 5 bit. So these two byte, right, are for this pixel information, the first pixel. Okay, and next two byte are for second pixel, right? And so on. So you need two byte in this case for to display color in, you know, one specific pixel, right? And if you select 555, then we don't use the MSB. And then 5 bit. So, you know, the same, right? Two byte are for, you know, one pixel, right? If you select 444, then we don't use, you know, first 4 bit, and then remaining 12 bit, right? 444 RGB. That is for, you know, one pixel. And again, the default setting, if you don't do anything, the default setting is YUV. This one, Dawn, can you please read?
Anyway, to cut it short, it's simple. YUV 422 looks like YUYV. This is a definition for two pixels. So it becomes Y0, U0, Y1, V0, where Y0, U0, V0 is for pixel 1, and Y1, U0, V0 for pixel 2. And now the...
Okay, thanks. So if you look at the data the data sheet, then this is the information, register information, right? And default value 0D. For this register, 88, okay, this register and so on. So if you look at this one, important thing is, I think this one, Y, U, Y, V, Y. Okay, first, write this one. COM7, right? COM. 8-bit register. Okay. 8-bit register, all zeros, eight zeros. So 00 means you are selecting YUV format. Okay. So that is default setting. Then you selected YUV, then more specifically, what kind of sequence do you want to send data, you know, to data to outside world? So you have to check this TSLB and 0D, right? 0D is what? In binary. 0D, right? Four zeros, and D is what? 1, 1, C, 1, right? So TSLB3, then you're talking about this bit, right? This one, 1, right? And 1, and COM13 this one, no, 8, 8. 8, 8 is, you know, 1, 3, 0, 1, 3, 0. So zero means, you know, zero, right? Zero bit, LSB, like three zeros, right? 1, 3, 0, 1, 3, 0. So we are talking about this bit, right? So 1, 0. 1, 0 means the video format is this one, UYVY, right? So that means, the video information will be sent like this. Okay, sent like this. A little bit confused, little confusing, right? So look at this. Again, you know, U and V are for color information. U and V, and Y is what? Y is brightness, right? Y zero, a brightness for first pixel, Y0, right? Y0, and Y1, right? Y1, brightness for second pixel, okay? Brightness, and U and V, color information. So we use the same U and V color information for these two pixels, okay? Like this, same U, V, U0, V0. So if you Google search with YUV422, the reason people use YUV422 is because human eyes are more sensitive to brightness than you know, colors, right? So if you use the same color information for two pixels, human eyes do not differentiate, right? Do not differentiate difference. If you, as long as you use the same different brightness, then human eyes are not that, you know, sensitive. It's okay to use this format. So that means what? That means, you know, these four bytes are for what? For two pixel information. Okay. And then Guyun's implementation is, we are not going to use, in our class, we are not going to use color information, U0, V0. We are using only brightness information, Y0, Y0 and Y1. So if you look at the hardware design, so Guyun is taking out only that part, this data, okay, Y0, and V1 data and store that. So in this design, this capture logic is taking every other byte, not, you know, all the byte, every other byte, right? This capture logic is taking every other byte and store that into this, you know, black RAM. Okay, because we are displaying a black and white, not color, black and white, you know, image information. Okay, that is the one. And let's talk about, you know, clock frequency. Okay, so if you look at this VGA timing diagram, so between V sync, vertical sync, right? So when you send, before you send whole one frame, you have to assert that vertical sync, right? Resync should be asserted. Then whole image should be sent. Then vertical sync is asserted. Then you are sending next frame, right? 640, 480, and so on. So in between these two, you are sending how many different lines? 480 in our lines. So in between, you are asserting href, okay, 480 times, right? So 480 times asserted. Then here you are sending this one line information, right? So look at this, you know, 5, 10. So even though you are sending 480 lines, then you need some, you know, some time between first line, right? First line, you are sending first line, row zero, right? And you need some time, right? 17 line time, right? Before you assert this one. But you don't have to worry about, you know, camera is sending information based on this, you know, timing diagram, right? And then each href, that is 640, the pixel time, right? Pixel time. And to send each pixel information, to send each pixel information TP, you need two clock cycles, two multiplied by TCLK, right? Like this. You need, for example, this information, right? You need two clock cycles to send one pixel information, right? Again, write this one, YUV RGB. You need two clock time, okay, to send information. So look at this formula, right? To send this one frame information, to send one frame information, you need this many clocks, okay? 5, 10 lines. 5, 10 lines. Then each line, because we need, you know, the assertion time, assertion, href, and the assertion, right? So that time is how long? 144. 144 pixel time. So if you add, you know, this one and this one, 784. So basically to send, you know, this information, to send one, you know, line information, right? You need that, you know, pixel time, 784 pixel time. That is including actual, right? Pixel, you know, actual time to send this pixel information, then some time, okay? Some preparation time, I don't know, some time, okay? 144 TP. So 510, each line is equivalent to this many pixels, right? This many pixels, right? Each line, right? Each line is equivalent to that many pixels. Then to send each pixel information, you need two clock cycles. So that is how many clocks you need. How many clocks, right, you need to send one frame information. Okay, then multiply that number by this one. You need to send, you know, 30 frames per second. 30, right, 30 of them. Okay, then you get this number. That is roughly 24 megahertz. Okay. So if you look at the specification, if you look at the specification, that is clock, right, input clock. So typical clock frequency it is expecting is 24 megahertz, 24, right? So camera module is expecting 24 megahertz to send that information, to send 640 by 480, one frame, and you need 30 frame per second, right? Send 30 frames per second. So again, if you look at this again, that is actual pixel, right, information, right? You are sending actual pixel information here during this time, href. Also here, second row, second line, third line, and the last line. But you need some, you know, some time in between, these two. You have to consider, right, that time too, right? So, you know, if you do the math, then that will be, you know, 24. But Guyun's design is a little bit, so Guyun, you know, double the clock frequency, not 24, you know, 48, right? Okay, it's supplying 48 megahertz. That means this camera module is sending actually 60, right? 60 frames per second. 60 frames per second, not 30 frames per second. So we did some experimentation, but so if you look at the spec says, where is that? Here, look at this. Maximum image transfer rate. 30 frame per second for VGA, but it seems like it is sending more than, you know, 30 frame per second, and it's 60 frame per second, right? So we had no problem by supplying 48 megahertz. So if you deploy ILA, then you can you know, prove internal signals, right? By measuring that, you know, time, we figure that that camera module is able to provide, you know, more than 30, so 60 frame per second, I think. Anyway, you know, system is working. So, any question about this? I'm trying to explain why we used that clock frequency, why we used the 48. So actually 24 megahertz should be supplied to get, you know, 30 frames per second, right? But we decided to double the clock. And the reason why this memory is this big is because we want to store that one frame data information. So if you do the math, then there is this number. So we created, you know, block RAM with that many locations. Okay, each location store one byte. Okay, that is input, format, okay, PL input, you know, format. Then output format should be this. Output means what? Output means this output. So we just talk about this input from this camera. And how about this output format? This output to VGA monitor. If you look at this, so if you Google search with VGA monitor, then that is the signal the VGA monitor is expecting. So even though you are displaying 640 by 480 video image, you have to send more data than, you know, this one. You have to send, you should send 800 by 525. Because you need some time, right? Some front porch and back porch. And between these two, you need a sink. Right? Horizontal sink and vertical sink. So 96 pixel words time, you need to deassert this horizontal sink. Okay, to indicate, okay, I sent one line information like this, right? Horizontal sync, right? I sent one line information, then deassert. Horizontal sync. Then after sending second line, so better to show you this, like this. After sending first line, you have to deassert, horizontal sync. After sending second line, deassert, same thing goes, right? And then between each frame, you have to deassert, vertical sync like this. Okay, that is VGA monitor is expecting. So we have to follow that that specification, right? So 800, 525, that format. So that is making hardware design a little tricky. So we have different input, even though this active, right? Even though active screen size is the same, right? Camera, right? Input side, output side. Active screen size, right? That is active screen size, 640 and 480. That is the same input and output, but the difference is, you know, this one, this additional time, right? 800, 525, the output. The input? Input is what? What is that? Input, this one, input, right? Input, 510? 510, okay. Instead of, input 784, right? 784 pixel time, then 510 lines, right? 784, right? Pixels, right? And then 525, right? 525? 510. 510 pixels. So that number, that is from camera, right? And output, that is input, and output is what? 800, right? 800 and 525. So we have a different resolution, right? Between input and output. So that make, hardware design a little bit tricky, right? That is why Guyun used that, you know, clock frequency, I think 48. Even though you need 24, then just use 48 to be on the safe side. Any questions so far? Okay, then. Let me check out, let's check out the hardware design a little bit. Okay. So let me open the top file is this one. Okay. So pretty straightforward design, I think, very intuitive design. So you have input, right? Output. So if you go to output side, 4-bit RGB, right? Here. 4-bit each. So 4-bit. Okay. So that is connected. That will be connected to, you know, VGA, you know, monitor, right? Through what? Through okay, this one, through this logic, right? So that 4-bit, this 4-bit, right? Jedboard schematic, that is coming out from Zynq device, right? 4-bit, right? Zynq device, RGB, right? 4-bit. And then going through this circuit, right? Register circuit, and that is converted to analog signal, some different voltage level. Then display some color. So if you follow this output, RGB, R, okay, that is coming from this VGA, right? VGA module. If you go to VGA, so we have a red, green, blue, RGB, 4-bit each, right? That is generating, this module is generating that output. If you go in R, right? VGA module, right? So search. Look at this. So you are assigning same, look at this. Same pixel information, to RGB. That means what? That means, you know, gray scale, you know, image. Right? So input, 4-bit input. Okay, so if you go who is sending that pixel information? Go up. Okay, VGA, pixel. It's coming from block memory, right? Which is this second. This second block memory, 4-bit. Sorry, this one's supposed to be 320, not 420. This one supposed to be 320. Okay, so essentially you are storing, right? This design is storing every other byte from input, right? Like, okay, here, like this. Every other byte, this Y0, Y1, luminance information, right? Luminance information, brightness information. So storing one frame worth, okay, one frame, this many, right? This many, you know, eight, you know, sorry, this many brightness information. And this core logic is simply reading 8-bit, okay? And, you know, reading 8-bit, then store this upper 4-bit, right? Very simple design, right? So reading 8-bit information from first memory, then take out this upper, you know, 4-bit, this upper 4-bit, and store that into second memory. Very simple, right? Store into, you know, second memory. Reading from first memory and take out this core logic is storing that into, you know, here. Very simple. The reason why we extract this 4-bit information is because VGA, right? This output should be, you know, 4-bit each, right? R 4-bit, green 4-bit, blue 4-bit. That is why we, you know, extracted upper 4-bit. And to send, right? To send this output information, look at this simple, you know, mess. To send output information, VJ, right? This output information, you need to send this many pixel, right? 800 pixels and 525 pixel information, right? So if you multiply that number with 30 frames per second, then you get this. That is roughly this megahertz, right? So roughly, you know, double. Okay. Okay, that is the one. And just for your information, I took this color conversion equation from this webpage. So once you have YUV information, you can convert that into RGB using this formula. Assuming YUV are 8-bit, okay, 8-bit, then you can convert that into, you know, RGB using this equation. Okay, I guess that is for today. Oh, anything you want to add, Guyun? You are the author. So anything you want to add?
코어에서 그 이미지를 후처리할 수 있게 넣어놓은 거고요. 좀 최적화를 하고 싶으시면 뭐 저 코어는 사실 원래는 없어도 되는 설계라는 것 정도만 이제 덧붙이면 될 것 같습니다.
Okay, so after midterm exam, we are going to implant DNN, right? Example DNN engine. To that, you know, base design, right? So, this is Lunet, right? The Lunet 5. So we are going to implant that DNN. Okay. Okay. We are going to implant that DNN model. Module design to here. Then what Guyun says is you can replace core, right? Guyun, that is what you're saying? You can replace this core logic with DNN. Is that what you're saying?
완벽히 그 대체하는 거는 아마 어려우실 거고 뭐 이제 필요에 따라서 이제 알아서 후처리를 해서 뭔가 그냥 변형하기 쉽게 넣어놓은 구조입니다. 네.
그러니까 아마도 이제 DNN 그 설계가 여기에 붙을 거고.
네, 맞습니다.
요 사이에. 그치?
네.
그러면 이 메모리에서 읽어 와서 이제 어떤 이제 이게 핸드리튼 레코그니션 모델이니까 이런 그 이미지를 카메라에 비춰 주면 카메라 비춰주면 그게 이제 여기 저장되겠고,
네.
그거를 이제 요 모델이 하나씩 불러와서 그 다음에 이제 판단을 하면 되지, 클래시피케이션을 하는 거지.
숫자가 아, 네. 되지.
그러니까 코어 로직이 리플레이스되는 건 아닌가? 이거랑?
제가 설계한 건 그냥 코어 로직에서 이제 DNN에 들어가는 인풋을 전처리하게만 설계를 해줬었습니다.
오케이, 코어 로직은 그대로 있고.
네.
그대로 있고, 그 르넷은 우리가 GitHub에서 또 그 레퍼런스 모델 레퍼런스로 설계한 게 있으니까 그걸 그냥 갖다가 그냥 쓰는 거죠 우리는.
여기 네 맞습니다.
오케이. 그래서 막 그 결과를 코어 로직 그 위에 그냥 박스 하나 더 있다고 생각하면 그게 이제 이 모델이 될 거고, 그 모델에서는 메모리에서 인풋을 받아서 처리를 하고 그 처리한 거를 VGA 통해서 이제 아 숫자가 7이다. 그게 뭐 디스플레이 할 수 있게 그렇게 설계가 되어 있는 거지 아마.
네 그렇긴 한데 그 말씀하신 거랑 딱 하나 다른 게 저 플럭 메모리 제너레이터 제로에서 받아오는 게 아니라 코어에서 이제 전처리한 데이터를 다른 추가적인 비램에서 받아오게 설계해놨습니다.
Okay. Okay. Any other things you want to mention? I guess that's it for today. That is pretty much the experiment environment and hardware design. You know, the hardware design itself is, it is, you know, once you understand the principle of hardware design, right? So if you look at this system value description, so for example, capture logic, right? If you go to capture logic, you know, hardware design is actually, you know, not that difficult once you understand the principle, right? What is principle? You know, there are two kinds of logic. What kind of logic? Combination logic, sequential logic, right? Combination logic and sequential logic, right? 조합회로 in Korean, and 순차회로, right? So combination, what is combination logic, right? Output depends only on input. So one simple example is this, right? One simple example of combination logic is, you know, AND gate, right? Output depends only on input, right? If you apply input, output depends on current input, only current input, right? Apply input, then output is determined. What is 순차회로, right? 순차회로 is output, right? There is, you know, some measure. Right? Output depends not only current input, right? A and B, but not only current input, but, you know, something stored inside this module, inside the flip-flop. We call that the state, right? State is determined based on what? Previous input, right? Previous. So you supply some, you know, input, and that information is essentially stored in flip-flop output. We call that state. So by combining state, previous input, and current input, you determine output. That is sequential logic, right? So essential component you need, you know, flip-flop, because flip-flop is storing the previous input into the queue output, right? And very important mechanism, right? Very important mechanism, or very important module, or very important what? So if you understand finite state machine, that is actually almost everything about digital logic design, finite state machine. Remember, you know, once you remember this state transition diagram, S0 to S1, S2, this kind of stuff, right? Reset, right? Some input, then you go to state one, right? Some input, some other input, then you go to state two, or you know, stay here, something like this. So depending on the input, right? Depending on input, you go to some state, right? Then that is the state, right? This state. State plus, you know, current input. Then that is determined output, right? So once you understand FSM, that is almost all about, you know, digital logic design. That involves not only this, you know, flip-flop, but also combination logic design, right? So that design is also based on the FSM, right? That is a backbone. Look at this. So, you know, acronym, Y is what? Y is luminance, right? And NY, according to Guyun's explanation, NY is not luminance. Okay, not luminance and luminance, right? You have only two state, three state, four state, sorry. So state machine design, right? So you have idle state, then you go to what? A rest state? Why you need that many states? Huyun. I don't know. NY state? And then Y state. So href, right? Then you are getting data, right? You are getting the data. U0, Y0, right? V0, Y1. So you are supposed to take out, you know, these two, every other byte, which are, you know, that ruminance information. So not Y, Y. Ruminance or not Y. So if you are in ruminance state, probably you take out that information, right? So FSM is almost you know everything about you know digital logic design. That is a backbone. So in reference to this state, you do some action. You are in NY state, and what do you have to do? You are in NY state. What do you have to do? In NY state, you take out this data and store that information into the memory, right? So you know, that is backbone. So why you need another state? What is this? What is this?
아마 아이들이 그 V-Sync가 올라가 있는 사이클 동안 아이들 상태로 유지가 되고 그리고 그 유의미한 데이터가 들어오지 않을 때가 REST 상태고 NY가 이제 UV 데이터가 들어올 때고 Y가 밝기 데이터가 들어올 때인 겁니다.
Okay, idle state. Okay, idle state you do something, right? REST state you don't do anything. Okay, output, right? And what is where is the state machine?
어, 그 아마
Oh, here is a state machine. This is a state machine. Right? So idle state. If Vsync is zero, you go to rest state, right? You go to rest state, right? And rest state, depending on this condition, you go to either here or you stay here or go back, right? Vsync is one, you go back to either. Href is one, you go to NY state. And otherwise you stay here, right? Otherwise you stay here. So there is a backbone. This state machine is backbone. Then based on state information, action, right? Action. This action, write enable action, right? Then this action. So passage clock, okay. Okay, so flip-flop, right? State machine is actually flip-flop. Then this one is also flip-flop, right? PCLK, passage. Okay, so probably some timing, okay? Because some timing, another flip-flop. Right? There is also a flip-flop. Okay. Anyway, you know, digital logic design is not, I would say very easy once you understand that principle, right? Okay, that is about capture logic, right? Capture logic, clock generator, and block memory, first block one, block memory, core logic, block memory, and VGA interface, right? And then this one is for configuration. So we don't use camera configuration, but if you go into camera config, this is the one. Then check out this config ROM. Go into the ROM. Then that is the one. It is programming. Programming configuration register. Inside that camera module. Right? So in this case, you are not doing anything. You are just reset or register the out. So here, if you turn on that statement, set operating mode to RGB and so on. So I2C, right? I2C, you know, connection. Right? I guess that's it. We can finish a little early today. If you don't have any question, then you can finish. Okay, that's it for today, and I'll see you on Tuesday on exam date. Okay. Okay, see you. Okay, thanks.